It's AumSum time! What if news disappeared?
Huh? Oh no! I was going to be interviewed today!
Oh, AumSum.
To buy this t-shirt, visit AumSum.com.
Firstly, if news disappeared, famous news anchors would have to look for a new job. Secondly, if news disappeared, popularity of cartoon channels might skyrocket. Thirdly, many people love to drink tea while reading a newspaper in the morning. If news disappeared, these people would be one sad lot. Fourthly, if news disappeared, newspapers might start publishing jokes instead of news. Lastly, celebrities as well as politicians are in the news every day. If news disappeared, these people would be extremely disappointed. What do dogs see when they watch TV?
They see it's AumSum time.
Dogs don't see what we see.
Why?
Because of flicker fusion rate.
What's that?
Let's turn this light on/off continuously. Can you see the flicker?
Yes.
Okay, now faster. Whoa, looks like a smooth continuous light without flicker. For humans, the flicker fusion rate is more than 55 times per second. Thus, television sets show 60 images per second, helping us perceive a smooth continuous video. However, dogs process visual information much faster, processing 70 to 80 images per second. Hence, the TV might appear to flicker to dogs. Also, dogs have dichromatic vision. That is, they can only see within the spectrum of yellow and blue. Thus, images on TV might appear as a meaningless yellowish-blue jumble. Further, dogs are seen to respond more to sounds like barking, meowing, etc. Why are tears salty?
Cause our eyes forgot to add sugar to them.
Just listen. There's no way that our tears cannot be salty because salt, that is, sodium chloride, is very essential for various bodily functions. Sodium in salt conducts nerve impulses, helps all the muscles to contract, etc. Chloride is an essential part of our stomach acid. According to research, there's about half a pound of salt in our bodies. Now, if we have so much salt, it makes sense that our bodily fluids, including sweat, blood, and tears, naturally have some salt in them. Besides this, it would take a lot of cellular energy to make sure that our tears were 100% pure water. Moreover, as some tears are continuously produced to lubricate our eyes, it is believed that salt in those tears inhibits the growth of bacteria, thus preventing infections. Why are prime numbers so weird?
Cause they are my brothers.
Nah. Numbers such as 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, and so on are prime numbers. But these look like ordinary numbers. Why call them weird? We call them weird because there are infinitely many prime numbers. There is no end. So, no one can find the biggest prime number. Every time, there will be a bigger one yet to be discovered. Also, did you know that a recently found prime number is so large that if written, it will need 9,000 pages of a book? This means they are so weird and complicated that even our advanced brains cannot decipher them. We need the help of supercomputers. If these numbers are so weird, why do we care so much about them? Because primes are used in credit card transactions, security codes, encrypted emails, etc. Without them, we couldn't securely perform all these tasks. Why do people smoke?
Because they love coughing.
No. Teens or young adults start smoking primarily because it feels glamorous and exciting. Watching friends as well as movie actors influences them as well. Cigarettes contain tobacco, which contain a highly addictive chemical called nicotine. When taken in, nicotine enters the bloodstream and quickly travels to the brain, releasing feel-good chemicals and removing unpleasant feelings. This helps adult smokers to cope with stress and stay focused. Shortly after completing the cigarette, a smoker starts feeling irritated and anxious. He starts feeling a mild nicotine withdrawal. On smoking the next cigarette, nicotine reaches the brain in less than 10 seconds, instantly giving a pleasant feeling and sense of calmness. This makes it very difficult to stop as the person starts becoming emotionally and mentally dependent on nicotine. This leads to many people becoming chain smokers, needing multiple cigarettes a day. Is diabetes hereditary?
Diabetes. Is that the name of a new donut?
No. There are two types of diabetes, type 1 and type 2. Type 1 diabetes generally appears during adolescence. However, it is not necessarily hereditary. In fact, the genetic features of a person make them more vulnerable to it, adding certain risk factors, like living in cold climates or contracting some stomach viruses are known to activate type 1 diabetes in people who are susceptible to it. Also, type 1 diabetes is seen more in children who haven't been breastfed sufficiently. But type 2 diabetes does have a strong connection to family history. Children of type 2 diabetic parents do have a high probability of getting diabetic. However, even though there is a strong genetic basis, lifestyle choices also have a significant impact. Maintaining an active lifestyle and staying fit can help people avoid type 2 diabetes. Is running bad for knees?
That depends.
On what?
Whether I am being made to run.
Oh, AumSum. Some people believe that running is bad for knees because it causes arthritis. However, research states the opposite.
Really?
Yes. Volunteers were made to run for 30 minutes on a treadmill. Post-running, certain substances associated with arthritis were found less in the synovial fluid present in the knee, and more in the blood. Thus, running might have squeezed these substances out of the knees, reducing the risk of arthritis. But yes, certain factors could cause trouble to the knees. Running on concrete surfaces can damage the cartilage and knee joints. The softer the surface, the more joint-friendly it is. Weight is another factor. Heavier the person, higher the risk of knee injuries. The right shoe choice is also important. And lastly, cartilage loss could happen with age, increasing the risk of knee injury. How much water should you drink per day?
68.2735649.81 liters.
Now, up to 60% of the human adult body is water. But every day, we lose some of this water through sweat, urine, etc. So we need to replenish it. Now, there's a popular 8x8 rule which says every day one should drink 8 glasses, each containing 8 ounces of water. Whereas, the Institute of Medicine suggests that the total water intake, including all beverages and food, should be 2.7 liters for women and 3.7 liters for men. However, no single formula fits everyone, but our amazing body itself tells us when we need water. For example, dark yellow urine is usually a very good sign of dehydration. Exercise, climate, and conditions like diarrhea, vomiting, etc. can lead to additional water loss. So, our body makes us feel more thirsty. This brings us to the conclusion that the water needs vary from person to person and situation to situation. Why do we blink?
To look adorable and innocent.
No. An average person blinks about 10 to 20 times per minute. Blinking helps spread water, oil, mucus, etc. across our eyes and wipe out dust. However, this is not the only purpose of blinking. Experts notice that the exact moments when we blink are not random. While reading, we tend to blink at the end of sentences. While listening, we blink when speaker takes pauses. Hence, using fMRI scanners, experts observed the brains of some individuals. The analysis showed that while blinking, mental activity dipped in areas which control attention, while the activity spiked in areas called default mode network. This network operates when mind is in a state of wakeful rest. Based on these observations, experts hypothesize that blinking acts as a tiny mental break, thus allowing us to pay more attention when we open our eyes again. Why is grass green?
'Cause green grass, blue sky, and brown mountains look great together.
No.
Huh?
First of all, we are able to see objects around us because they reflect the sunlight falling on them. Sunlight is comprised of a full spectrum of colors including violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. The color of an object depends on which color of sunlight it reflects.
Ah.
Now, strawberries have a pigment called anthocyanin. It absorbs all colors except red. It reflects red. Hence, strawberries appear red. Coal absorbs all colors and doesn't reflect any. So, it appears black. Now, coming back to the question, the grass appears green because its cells have a special pigment called chlorophyll in them. Chlorophyll absorbs colors like red and blue and mostly reflects green. As this reflected green color reaches our eyes, we perceive the grass as green.